Would you give this to a 5-year-old girl for her birthday? How about that? Around 30% of workers in STEM are women. Around 20% of C-level positions in the technology sector are women. Now, what does a gift at the age of 5 has to do with the number of women in STEM, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics? Let me start at the beginning. Is this a boy or a girl? To be fair, I don't know the right answer neither. But I'm sure we all had a guess in mind, right? But this was not always the case. Sometimes in the 20th century, manufacturers and the marketing industry realized that they could sell a whole new set of clothes, books, toys to wealthier families if they were marketed differently for boys and girls. Suddenly, a brother and a sister didn't want to read the same books, play with the same toys, or wear the same clothes. Pink for girls, blue for boys. Cute for girls, strong for boys. Dreamy for girls, bold for boys. Our children are shown very clearly what they should like, how they should look like, how they should behave. And it's not the marketing industry alone. Parents and caregivers support the message, either consciously or unconsciously. You might now say, this is just how it is. Girls are cute, well-behaved, they don't like analytical topics. They want to play with unicorns and dolls, and not with robots and dinosaurs. My question to you, is it nature or nurture? In 2017, the BBC did an experiment with adults. They brought in 1-year-old boys and girls and swapped their clothes. So the boys would wear dresses and the girls would wear shirts and dark blue pants. Then they asked the adults to play with the children. Now let me cut the story short. The adults' picks were based on the assumed gender. So the child in a dress got to play with the soft toy and the doll. And the child in boys' clothes got to sit in a car and play with a robot. How would you now answer the question, is it nature or nurture? Our children encounter stereotypical behavior towards them from a very early age, and it goes throughout their whole childhood. Around the age of 3 to 5, children start paying attention to belonging and gender identity. They want to be part of a group. Research has shown that at that age, the label of a toy is actually more important than the toy itself. So if you put a new toy in front of a child and say, this is a toy for boys, the boys will be more inclined to play with it. I know a 5-year-old girl, and she has an older brother. She wants to be just like him, so she wants to be part of his group. And that's actually more important than belonging to the girls' group. Now, she's a very strong and independent person, but guess what? She likes climbing, she wants to be a football player. She does not want to wear dresses. If it was up to her, she would wear her football jersey to every occasion. But why do we even need more women in STEM? And who am I to talk about that? Jobs in STEM have a high potential for big innovations. And they're very often well paid. So balancing out the ratio between men and women is not just a question about diversity. It is also an economic necessity. Many companies experience a shortage of qualified professionals. And we, as a society, dismiss around half of the population from when they are born. In my career as a project manager for software development projects, I was very often one of the only women in the room. Today I have 3 daughters, and I want them to sit in a diverse room when they grow up. Now, I'm sure some of you think, we always say we need more women in STEM, but look at where we are. Nothing changes. If you ask me, the reason why nothing changes is because we start too late. we raise our children with the idea that STEM is for boys. We then say, oh, there is not enough women in STEM. So we work with teenage girls and women that are already in the workforce and convince them to move into STEM. How about we start at the age of 7, when we tell girls that math is as much for them as it is for boys? Or how about starting at the age of 5, when we bring a robot to a girl's birthday party? Or how about even starting at the age of 1, when we buy the girl a car to sit on instead of another soft toy? Following the saying, be the change you want to see in the world, I founded an anti-stereotypical clothing brand for boys, for girls. That will be another topic. I've made it my mission to empower girls and show them that STEM is as much for them. If we never show our girls that STEM is not for them, we will never have to convince them that it actually is. Now, I realize this is a very easy thing to say, but very difficult to do. Changing unconscious bias and stereotypical thinking is not just something you do easily. It takes a lot of effort and willingness to change. And we all need to be aware of our own stereotypical thinking. I myself have to be very conscious about that. Bringing a robot to a 5-year-old girl's birthday party is not something you do naturally. At the same time, manufacturers and the marketing industry need to realize that doing advertisement based on a classification that is not meaningful is not helpful. And some countries have already started. Spain, for example, does not allow gender stereotypical marketing for toys. If saying we need more women in STEM, we need to start at an early age with our children. I don't know who decided that robots are for boys. I do know that girls can like them just as much if we let them. Similarly, we don't need to push women into STEM. We need to stop discouraging young girls from exploring the field. So let's normalize giving girls all options available. Whether that option comes in the form of a bold t-shirt, a chemistry kit, or something as simple as a toy robot. Thank you very much.